Hey everybody, Joseph Rothschild here, aka MonoBlueTron, back again with another episode of 10 Minute Testing. Now here on 10 Minute Testing, we endeavor to show you some of the first competitive footage of new decks, cards, and archetypes, which is why I hope you'll enjoy this video on the new Musket link about 3 months after it was spoiled. I deeply apologize to all of my subscribers who are Magical Musket fans, yes, both of you, and I hope to do better in the future. In the meantime, let's jump into deck edit and see just how much of a double helix this guy is. So here's the list, and shockingly, it's not that different than the last time we took a look at it. As always, I'll give you a little bit of background about the archetype, a little bit of a discussion about what I hope the deck can do, and as always, the card by card. So firstly, Magical Musketeer, localized from Magibullets, is an archetype of fiends with guns. That's right, guns in Yu-Gi-Oh! Cue the censors, I already know I'm getting demonetized. The Magical Musketeers all enable you to use their on-theme spells and traps, their muskets, so to speak, from your hand, then get an additional effect if a spell or trap is activated in the same column as the one they occupy. In the past, this has lured deck builders onto traps like Toon Table of Contents, but like early Sky Striker builds, the deck is now much better off by only playing good cards. It's an impressive strategy, but relying on either drawing Ties of the Brethren or slowly grinding your way to a playable board with repeated normal summons isn't exactly anything to write home about. Despite that, it has remained a fan favorite and rogue playable archetype since its release. Until now. In the newly spoiled Link Vrains Pack 2, there exists a card that might finally unlock Magical Musketeer's potential as the next Zodiac. Magical Musketeer Max, is a Link 1 who can be made off of any Musketeer level 8 or lower, and adds either spells and traps equal to your opponent's monster count, or special summons monsters equal to your opponent's spell and trap count when it's summoned. This means that all of a sudden, the slow grind that was the hallmark of Musket's lethargic pace of gameplay has been accelerated to a fever pitch of Link summoning madness and plus fours. The immense searchability Max adds means you're now able to play significantly more utility one-ofs, and the fact that he doesn't lock you into Muskets after summoning monsters means you can easily OTK with Boral Sword should you so desire. In previous looks at this deck, I wrote it off as another deck with the ships and pilots problem. You need both spells and monsters in your opener to pop off, but since you can almost always get guarantee you'll have the pieces you require in your hand, the flex slots in this deck can now be safely filled with format staples like Ash Blossom, Called by the Grave, and Infinite Impermanence, as well as wind stealers like Gozen Match. So with that, let's get into the card by card. First, the Musketeers. The deck's down to just the good stuff, one copy of Starfire, three copies of Shooter the Kid, three Doc, and three Kaspar. Rounding out our monster lineup is three Ash Blossom. For spells, we've got three Desires, three Ties of the Brethren, still our best turn one option, three Called by the Grave, which is honestly just as good for the deck as the Link, three Cross Dominator, monster negations at a premium, and one Steady Hands. What? It's searchable. Finally, we've got an Upstart Goblin before we get into our traps. Three Infinite Impermanence, three Gozen Match, 3 Desperado, 3 Dead Man's Burst, and 1 Devil Deal, its searchable protection for your fragile normal summon. In the extra, we've got Fortress for those pesky Sidra players, Nightmare's Unicorn, Phoenix, Cerberus, and Shark, get it? Stone King, Grandpulse, Gossip Shadow, Dante, Boral Sword, Master King, Hippo Shinigan, and the only one we'll ever go into, 3 Brave Maxol. So with that, let's jump into the games. Our first match is up against Pendulum, and unfortunately for us, our deck elects to go second. Nothing sets up quite like Pendulum. Thankfully, we do have a copy of Infinite Impermanence for the Electromite, and we will force them to play fair. They're going to start by activating the effect of Curtain Razor to special summon it, then normal summoning a Purple Poison going into Electromite. We will negate its effect as soon as possible. We don't want them popping off. They'll go ahead and set Scales, one of which is a Wisdom Eye Magician, to get themselves a Black Fang, then Pendulum summon two monsters, go into a Tornado Dragon, and pass it back to us. Things are looking pretty good because we have a Ties of the Brethren in our hand. We draw Shooter the Kid, which is better. We'll go ahead and activate Ties of the Brethren to get ourselves a copy of Doc and a copy of Kaspar, then activate the effect of Shooter the Kid to discard the extra Doc, then we'll Desperado this copy of Tornado Dragon to add a Dead Man's Burst to our hand, then use the effect of Doc on the Upstart Goblin to get that Desperado back, set two and pass. Our opponent's going to start by activating Black Fang. We will Desperado this copy of Electromite in response so they don't get the draw. Black Fang is going to bring back this Purple Poison. We'll go ahead and draw a couple of cards while we're at it. Our opponent's going to activate Wisdom Eye. We will Dead Man's Burst it, trying to set them off Scales. They will next activate this copy of Wisdom Eye again. We thankfully do have Infinite Transience, so we can negate its effect, it can't be destroyed, and as a result they're forced to perform a mediocre Pendulum summon followed by a Carnegorgon. They'll attack, and in the damage step we'll use Cross Domination to deal 800 points of damage. From here we should easily be able to win because of course they have spells and traps on their side of the field. We'll go into Max, use his effect to special summon two monsters from deck. Wow, that's amazing. Normal summon a Shooting Star, and they'll concede. Speaking of decks I don't want to see when I'm going second, our second opponent is on Altergeist. Thankfully, their hand isn't amazing. They have a copy of Marionetter, which sucks, and a copy of Metaverse, which will find that one of Silver Bullet that strikes fear into my heart, but nothing else. It's not like they have a multi-faker or any kind of play extender. They're going to start by normal summoning this copy of Marionetter, setting a copy of Materialization, telegraphing at least one protocol, and passing it back to us. We have open ties, so we'll go ahead and normal summon this copy of Kaspar and ties targeting it. They will respond with a copy of Metaverse, putting this copy of Secret Village into their hand, I think afraid we're going to destroy it with a Death Barado. We'll activate the effect of Kaspar, that'll prompt a protocol out of our opponent. We'll then activate the effect of Kid, because it's in the same column. They will respond with a Materialization. We'll go ahead and activate Pot of Desires, and they reveal a second copy of Protocol. We can pop off here. We're going to do so with Death Barado, add a copy of Kaspar back to our hand, and pass it to our opponent. Before they can activate this copy of Secret Village, we're going to go ahead and activate Devil Deal, protecting our monsters. We'll activate the effect of Dock, which gets negated by Protocol, but not destroyed. They're going to activate said Secret Village and pass it back to us. Thank God they don't have another copy of a Spellcaster. We're going to cycle this copy of Cross Domination at end step and then go into Max. We'll activate the effect of Max, and there is the Impermanence. Okay, well, that should mean the shields are down. We're going to normal summon a Kaspar, get in for 1,000. There is the Kunkieri. And before we're targeted off of spells, we're going to go ahead and increase the attack of our copy of Shooter the Kid so it can get over it. It will do so, and then we'll get in for 1,200 points of damage. We'll pass it back to our opponent with two more set. They draw dead, and they concede. Alright, so it's time for game 3, and you know what that means, a best of 3 versus meta. Since we've beaten a couple of competent decks already, we're aiming straight for the top and playing against Sky Striker, and oh, it finally happened. After 1,000 matches against this deck, they've bricked! Our opponent's going to set 3 cards and pass it back to us. That sets off a lot of warning bells. We're going to go ahead and assume there's a Solemn set there, so we probably won't go into Max this turn. Instead, we're going to normal summon a copy of Shooter Star, activate this Pot of Desires, and there is the Shared Ride. Okay, there's 2 left. They're going to Ash Blossom the effect of Shooter Star, which is one more card I don't have to worry about. We'll get in for 1,300 and pass it back. At end step, they're going to activate Twin Twisters, but we drew Dead Man's Burst. Provided that set card isn't anything and the card they draw for turn isn't, we could be in the clear. They draw an Upstart, they fire it off, and what do they find but an Eagle Booster? Kind of feels like we got away with murder on that one, but against Sky Striker, we take those. Unfortunately, our opponent has gotten wise to our trickery and is making us go first. That's great news for them, because our hand is terrible. We're going to start by normal summoning a Kaspar, setting 2, and praying. Our opponent draws for turn a second copy of Terraforming. They will set one of them and then target it with an Area 0. Of course they find the multi-roll. Why wouldn't they? They're then going to activate a second copy of Terraforming and a multi-roll, targeting this copy of Area 0, to get a Ray to board. They'll go to battle phase. We will activate Cross Domination, not in the damage step, so we can get the Kaspar activation. When they chain the effect of Ray, we will activate Called by the Grave. It's a little cute, but gets us the Death Barado we're going to need in order to destroy this copy of multi-roll. Unfortunately, they have the engage for the afterburner, and if we don't have a magical musketeer on our side of the board, we can't activate Death Barado. They're able to set 3 and pass it back to us. We can, at the very least, go into a copy of Max after using Doc's effect, but they do have a copy of Ash Blossom to prevent the special summon from deck. We're going to set 2 cards and hope for the best, but one of these two is Gozen Match, so it might work. They're going to activate Startup Engage, getting a Ray and finding a Widow Anchor. They'll attack, and this time in damage step, we'll activate Cross Domination. We have prevented any of the relevant Sky Strikers from coming out, but unfortunately this reset afterburners means that Gozen Match is not long for this world. We draw for turn, it's another Dock. If we can resolve Max, we might still win, but of course there's the Widow Anchor, and this is going to be the end of the game. Alright, so it's time for that all-important game 3, and we are going second. What's better is that our opponent's opener isn't fantastic. As long as it's not too explosive, we might be able to beat it. They're going to start with an Upstart Goblin, finding an evenly matched, followed by a Foolish Burial Goods for a Metal Foes Fusion. They're going to Area 0, targeting the set card. As long as they don't find exactly multi-roll, we should be in the clear. They're going to activate multi-roll to get a Ray from deck, then they're going to activate Metal Foes Fusion's Grave Effect to find a reinforcement of the army, a second Ray, go into Kagari, use Kagari to add back the field spell, which they will activate before going into Shizuku, and at end step doing the Shizuku Shuffle to set a copy of Widow Anchor. We draw for turn. The first thing we're going to do is normal summon Kaspar before activating Ties of the Brethren. This prompts a Widow Anchor from our opponent, so we don't get the effect, but we do still get the special summon. We'll get a Dock and a copy of Shooter the Kid. We're then going to activate Never Endorphin on Dock to cycle a little bit, then activate Pot of Desires to draw a couple of cards. We'll use Dock and pass it back to our opponent. We get back Kaspar, which is great. They draw Metal Foes Fusion, which is better. We're going to Death Barado, this copy of Area 0. They will respond with a Twin Twister, but we have a Dead Man's Burst. Things are looking great because that card they targeted is in fact Gozen Match. We will use Shooter the Kid's effect, Kaspar's effect, and then Chain Link 4 Gozen Match to prevent the special summon off of the Area 0. They will attack into our copy of Kaspar. That's fine. I want a water monster on my opponent's side of the field. They'll then activate Metal Foes Fusion, find a second Ray. We will trigger the effect of Dock with Devil Deal in end step and draw for turn. First thing we're going to do is go into Max. We'll use Max to special summon a Shooter the Kid. Afterwards, we're going to normal summon a Shooter Star, go into battle phase, in damage step, activate Never Endorphin on this copy of Shooter the Kid. When Ray comes out in damage step, we're going to activate Cross Dominator and get in for big damage. We have a negate and a pop in our hand. Things are looking pretty good, and our opponent can't activate evenly matched no matter how quickly they go into the battle phase because of this errant copy of multi-roll, which we will destroy now. We draw for turn, and that last set card is a Widow Anchor. We're going to go ahead and attack. They flip the Widow Anchor, but we have exactly one Dead Man's Burst left, and we're able to get in for lethal. 1600, 1400, and 1300. Ooh, tense one there. I'd like to thank Gozen Match, the fairest card ever printed. We're back with the deck, and wow, it is completely different. It is not as drastic as the Spiral change was, but the deck has gone from open ties or die, and then occasionally die anyway, to an unreal advantage threat. First, the pros. One, no one's FTKing anymore. It's not a big deal that you elect to go second when so many meta archetypes are particularly bad at doing anything but accruing advantage turn one, and that's exactly the thing that Max punishes. Two, it's extremely consistent. You don't have to open Kaspar or else, anything can turn into Kaspar should you so desire by using Max's effect. And three, Called by the Grave to three is amazing for the deck. The archetype struggles to play around cards like Pankratops and hand traps like Ash Blossom, and this both deals with them and triggers Musketeers. And the cons. First, presumably, this has a bad Thunder Dragon matchup. You can only add spells and traps with Max, since, you know, they never set anything, and I can't think of a cleanout to Superbolt. Two, it's fragile. If people board instant speed monster destruction, you'll waste your normal summon a significant amount of the time. If stuff like Solemn Warning and Solemn Judgment becomes more popular, there's not a lot you can do about it. Even Strike requires that you open Dead Man's. And three, we're judging this based on day one play. If people become more practiced, holding negation until max, reading cards in hand, then it's certainly possible that the deck takes a big hit in playability. Honestly, that said, I was still kind of struggling to figure out why this wasn't going to be playable. Even in the game we lost, our opponent had to chain negate every max we ever summoned, or else they lost instantly. If that doesn't scream Helix, I don't know what does. So that's that. With any luck, this will be airing during the holiday season. I'm recording it in advance so I can spend time with my family and not thinking about a children's card game. If you want to see me play the decks I make on this show on stream, I'm on twitch.tv/monoblutron every Monday from 10 to midnight Eastern Standard Time, and if you have an idea for a deck or archetype you want to see me examine on a future episode of this show, let me know in the comments section and I'll do my best. Otherwise, I'll see you next time.